Hey guys, today we will create the stylized tree in Blender and create some more variations. Let's select everything, X to delete, Shift A, mesh circle, set vertices to 5, S to scale, something like that. Now go to the front view, you can also do it by using numpad 1. Tap to enter the edit mode, A to make sure that all vertices are selected, E to extrude, S to scale, E to extrude, S to scale, E to extrude, S to scale, and E to extrude, S to scale. Just make a random tree shape. Now let's enable the wireframe view, so we can select all of these vertices without rotating the camera. And tweak the tree shape a bit. Switch to the other side view. Maybe select those and rotate. Rotate the camera around and see how it looks. Okay, now I'm happy with the tree shape. Let's enable solid view. Select any of the top vertices. FF to fill in the faces. Move down and Ctrl R to add an edge loop, left click to move, right click to confirm at the default position. Again, Ctrl R, left click, move it down like that, and left click to confirm at the new position. Switch to the face select. Let's select maybe this face. E to extrude, S to scale. G to move it down, something like that. Do the same here. Ctrl R, add an edge loop, move it down, left click to confirm. Make sure you are in the face select mode. Let's select this one. E to extrude, S to scale, G to move, and R to rotate. And the last branch at the top. I'm happy with the base mesh. If we look down here, we have a triangle count. To enable it, right click on this bottom line and enable scene statistics. Here we can see that my tree mesh has 107 triangles. Let's optimize it even more. Switch to the vertex select. Select this vertex. Hold shift and select two more. Press G twice, so GG, and slide vertices like that. Left click to confirm. Now our vertices overlap. If you select it, you can see it. To fix that, we need to merge them together. A to select all vertices, right click, merge vertices by distance. Now, if you select a vertex, you can see that they are merged together. And our triangle count is lower. Do the same here. Select these. Press GG and move it like that. And do the same here at the top. Also, let's select this one. GG and move to any side. A to select all vertices. Right click, merge vertices by distance. And now, if you check it, all of the overlapping vertices are merged together. So, by doing that, we are down to 87 triangles instead of 107. And we didn't lose any quality of the mesh. The tree looks the same. Tab to exit the edit mode. And we are done with the base of the tree. Now let's make some leaves. Shift A, mesh, circle. Set vertices to 7. Switch to the top view. G to move. X by X axis. Hold Ctrl to snap it to the grid. Left click to confirm. Just move it to the side so it is easier to work with. Tab to enter the edit mode. With all vertices selected, G to move, Y by Y axis, hold Ctrl to snap it to a grid, select bottom vertices, S to scale, and do the same with other vertices. Select the top one, G, Y to move up by Y axis, and repeat the steps until you make a shape of a leaf. Now select the top vertex, F to fill in the faces, switch to the side view, enable wireframe view, select these vertices, enable proportional editing tool, R to rotate, scroll middle mouse button to change the proportional editing size, and bend the leaf like that. Disable proportional editing tool. Tab to exit the edit mode. R to rotate. Something like that. Switch back to the solid view. Tab to enter the edit mode. Switch to the top view. Ctrl R. Left click. And right click to add an edge loop at the center. Select these two vertices. J to join them together with an edge. Select two vertices in the middle. Switch to the side view. G to move them up a bit. Something like that. Also select the middle back vertex, G, Z to move it up by Z axis. Let's select these back vertices. Press S, 0 and hit Enter to scale vertices down to the center. A to select all, right click merge vertices by distance, so it's merged into one vertex. Tab to exit the edit mode. We are done with a leaf shape. Now we will UV unwrap the mesh. Let's open the UV editing workspace. Tab to exit the edit mode. Select the mesh. Ctrl A, rotation and scale. Do it before unwrapping so you won't get any strange stretching in the UV map. Tab to enter the edit mode, A to select all vertices, U unwrap, select our new UV map, R to rotate so it sits straight, G to move near the edges, S to scale, make sure to leave a little gap between all of the leaf edges. Enable UV sync selection. Select the UV map bottom vertex. You can see which one it is in the 3D view. I want this vertex to be at the bottom of the UV map. So select the UV map and rotate it by 180 degrees. This is completely optional step. I like this way because it is easier for me to remember which part is which when we create color gradient. So, UV map for the leaf is done. Let's go back to the layout workspace. We will create UV map for the tree later on. Let's rename the leaf and the tree meshes. Select the leaf, Shift D to duplicate, and move it to the side. M, new collection. Let's call it backup. And hit OK. Now we have a new collection with a backup leaf mesh just in case. Let's hide the collection backup and continue. Select the leaf, Alt G to move it to the center of the grid, G Z to move it up by Z axis. Make sure that the leaf is intersecting with the tree, so it looks like it is connected to the tree. Let's scale it down a bit. I will also rotate it down more. Something like that. Switch to the top view. Shift D to duplicate, right click to confirm the default position, R to rotate. G, Z to move it down by Z axis so it doesn't overlap with the other leaf. Hold Shift to select both leaves. Back to the top view. Shift D to duplicate, right click to confirm default position, R to rotate. Left click to confirm, and again duplicate, rotate. Make sure that leaves doesn't overlap each other. Let's make them more random by moving some of the leaves up or down. Okay, now it looks better. Let's select all of the leaves. Duplicate and move up by Z axis. R to rotate, Z by Z axis. Try to fill in the gaps while looking from the top. And scale it down a little bit. Just make sure that all of the leaves are intersecting with a tree. And repeat all of the steps again. Here I will rotate some leaves to cover the tree more. Our tree looks pretty nice already. Let's finish up the top. I think there are too many leaves at the top, so let's delete a few. Here I decided to change the top leaf shape a bit. Select a leaf and go to the edit mode. Enable proportional editing tool. And with a top leaf vertex selected, rotate it. Select the bottom vertex and rotate even more. Something like that will do. Let's grab another one and do the same. Now let's add some more leaves at the very top. Let's make this leaf narrower. Select two vertices at the side. Turn off proportional editing. And press GG to slide vertices along edges. Okay, that's good enough. Rotate it to cover more of a tree and continue adding leaves. I will use this leaf for the very top. Move leaf origin point to the center of a tree top. Make sure it doesn't overlap. Duplicate it. RZ to rotate by Z axis. And add the third one. And this will be our tree top. Let's tweak some more. And we are done modeling the tree. Now, let's select all leaves. You can do it by holding Shift. Or select the tree mesh. Ctrl-I to invert selection. So, all of the leaves are selected now. Hold Shift and select any leaf to make it active. Ctrl-J to join all selected meshes into one. Now, we have two meshes. Leaves mesh. And tree mesh. Let's continue by UV unwrapping and texturing our stylized tree. Select the leaves mesh and switch to UV editing workspace. Ctrl-A to deselect everything. Make sure that UV sync selection is enabled. Here we can see that all of our leaves uses the same UV map, because we already UV unwrapped the leaf mesh. L to select individual leaves, you can see that all of them share the same UV map space, and they are overlapping. Ctrl-A to deselect, L to select top leaves, you can see that those leaves has narrower UV islands. That's because I used GG to slide vertices along edges before to make them narrow. Doing that updated the UV map. I want all UV islands to be identical, so let's fix that. Switch to the vertex snapping. Select those vertices. G to move. Hold Ctrl to snap it to other vertices. And do it for all four corners. That's it. Now all of the leaves uses exactly the same size UV islands. And all of them are overlapping, which is what we want. Exit the edit mode. Let's UV unwrap V3 mesh. Select it. Ctrl A, rotation and scale. Always do it before unwrapping the mesh to prevent UV map from stretching. Switch to the front view. Enter the edit mode. A to select all vertices. U, project from view. And this will be our tree UV map. Let's move it to the side and scale it up. Just make sure to leave some space around. That will do. Now, if we exit the edit mode, select both meshes by holding shift and enter the edit mode again. Alt A to deselect everything. Now we can edit both UV maps at the same time. And this is very useful because we will use the same texture on both meshes. A to select all UV islands. Go to UV, export UV layout. Let's call it tree_UV. Format PNG, texture size 1K. Export UV layout. Let's open image editing software. I will be using Affinity Designer. You can use Photoshop, GIMP, Krita or anything else that allows you to create gradients. Okay, let's create a new image, size of 1K. Go to the document setup. Open the color tab and check transparent background. Make sure that your image is transparent. Drag and drop our tree UV image. Move it to the center. And lock it so we can't accidentally move or edit it. Select the rectangle tool. Create the rectangle on top of the tree. And move the rectangle layer below the UV map. Just make sure that it covers the whole tree and has some space around. Select the fill tool. Make sure it uses the default settings. Click and hold on top of the rectangle. Drag the mouse down and release to make a gradient. My snapping was enabled during this. Now click on the top circle. And change to any color for the top of a tree. I will be using this color. Click on the bottom circle and set the second color. My second color. The tree gradient texture is done. Let's rename the layer to tree. And now we'll create a leaf texture. Select the pen tool. Left click to add a point almost at the bottom. Zoom out. Click and drag the mouse to make a curve along the UV map. And release the mouse. Hold Ctrl to move this handle. And adjust it to create a nice curve without going out of the UV map boundaries. Hold Ctrl to move this point too. And here is my curve inside the UV map boundaries. Click on the bottom point and drag the mouse down to make another curve. As you can see, the top of the curve strangely bends. To fix that, we need to edit this handle. Hold Ctrl-Alt and left-click to move only one handle. If needed, do the same with the bottom one. Okay, that is good enough. Now we can hide the tree UV layer. Since we don't need a curve line color, we can set it to transparent. Now we can select the fill color and set it to green. Let's rename the layer to leaf. Enable the gradient tool and add a gradient to the leaf. Select the top circle and set the first color. Select the bottom circle and set the second color. Tweaking colors a bit. And we are done with a gradient texture. Let's export it and try it in Blender. First, I will save the Affinity Designer file, just in case. Now go to File, Export, choose PNG, and export 1K texture. Let's call it tree. Go back to the Blender, switch to the shading workspace, select the tree, go to materials and add a new material. Let's call it tree. Set the roughness to 1 so it is not reflective. Shift A, texture, image texture. Open. Tree PNG. Connect the color output to the color input. And here we have a tree gradient texture applied to the tree mesh. Slash to isolate the tree so we can see the gradient better. Now select leaves. Hold shift and select the tree. Ctrl L, link materials. Now leaves mesh uses the same material as a tree mesh. If you look at the leaves, we have a black color, where it is supposed to be transparent pixels. To fix that, connect alpha output to the alpha input. And inside the materials, settings, change blend mode to alpha clip. And that's it, we have a transparent leaf texture. Let's make leaves mesh smooth. Select the leaves mesh, right click, shade smooth. Now we look nice and smooth. You can do the same with the tree mesh, but I will leave it flat shaded. Let's switch back to the Affinity Designer and add more detail to the leaf texture. Select the pen tool, set fill to white color. Imagine creating a cut inside the leaf. Create a triangle and set fill color to white. Let's create a few more cuts. Hold Ctrl to move points. Once you are done, switch to the node tool, so you can easily move those points. Switch to the move tool. Select all white shapes we just created and move layers on top of leaf layer. Make sure that the leaf layer is below white shape layers. Select the leaf layer, Ctrl G to duplicate just in case, and hide it. Now let's select all of the white shapes and the leaf layer and click on Subtract. By doing that, we made real cuts in the leaf texture. Export the texture and overwrite tree PNG. Switch back to Blender. Open the UV editing workspace. Make sure that tree PNG is open in the UV editor. Hover the mouse on top of the texture and press Alt R to update the texture changes. Now go back to the layout workspace and switch to the material preview. The tree is done. Continue watching to see how we can quickly create different tree variations. First, select the leaves. Hold Shift, select the tree. Ctrl J to merge them together into one mesh. Shift D to duplicate the tree. G, Y to move by Y axis. Enter the edit mode. Alt A to deselect everything. And let's remove some leaves. L to select individual leaves. Just do it randomly. X, vertices, to delete selected vertices. Let's delete some more. Tab to exit the edit mode. We are done with this tree. Let's duplicate it again, move it to the side, enter the edit mode, and remove some more leaves. Okay, I like that. And for the last tree, remove all of the leaves. And that's a very fast way to make quick tree variations. Let's add a plane. S to scale, to make a ground. Switch to the rendered view. Open the world properties and change the color to a light blue. Something like that. Add a sun. Move it up and rotate. RZ to rotate by Z axis. Okay, I like how the shadows fall on the ground. Let's change the strength of the sunlight to 5. And the color to a very light yellow. Okay, that looks pretty good. Now, open the render properties. Enable ambient occlusion. Let's increase the shadow resolution to 4K and enable these two options. Now we have nice and crisp shadows. Select the leaves, go to materials, change the shadow mode to alpha clip, and look how the leaf shadows change. Now we can see the leaf cutouts. Shadows now support the alpha texture. That's it! I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and found it helpful. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more.